Listen, I don't like Russell Westbrook on the Lakers. I'm gonna sit out for a second.
Why?
I'm gonna give you a little. I'm gonna give you the first shot here, pal.
I actually kind of love this.
Okay, I figured you would.
Oh, go ahead. I don't know how I always feel. Not like in totality, but always, and meaning in certain situations, I absolutely love Russell Westbrook. But there are other situations where he just frustrates the hell out of me, whether it's his propensity to miss and take excessive three-point shots, which he stopped doing at the end of last season, which was a good thing for them. Sometimes it's like his attitude just rubbed you the wrong way. But other times it's like, dude, I love that guy because he grinds and he's going to play every single minute if he can, and he's never turned off, ever. Right? He doesn't take the regular season as a warm-up to the postseason. I'm going all out all the time. And so I think the reason I like him with the Lakers, BT, is because when you look at this Lakers construction, they've gotten older, obviously, because LeBron is now 36, going to be 37 years old. AD, who's always injury prone, he's actually getting up there a little bit in age. Not that Russell Westbrook
is 27.
Young. But you know what I mean.
He's 27. 28.
How old is AD?
28? Yeah, not 30 yet, like that's for sure.
He's been around. That's right. He came in the league when he was 18.
Played one year.
So here's it. So at the end of the day.
He feels older. I got you on that.
Right. He feels like he's been around forever. Let's put it that way. Uh-huh. And even if he's not that old, he plays like he is.
His body feels that old because he's always hurt.
Russell Westbrook is the guy that they need to give it to them every single night. Mm-hmm. I don't know if that's going to translate in the postseason because we saw how bad he was in the postseason in some of these games, but he doesn't have to be a great scorer for this Lakers team. He just needs to be the accent piece. Now, they gave up a lot for him. That's one reason not to like this, but to have a trio of stars and to have bucket getters on three different levels, so to speak, with now Russell Westbrook in the fold, I think it completes their team in a way that lets them rush towards another final. Like, I don't think this team, if they stayed the way that they were going to be able to compete with what
the Warriors
are going to do, or what the Jazz have done.
Mm-hmm.
Or
Denver's getting better, healthy again with Murray.
Murray gets healthy, and we're discounting the Suns, who were just in the NBA Finals. Like, the West is loaded.
Yep,
and so I think they had to do something.
Yeah,
and this was the best option that was left out there.
I'll feel a lot better about the Lakers if they actually get DeMar DeRozan. Now, I don't know if that's going to happen. See, let me unpack this from a few different angles. Now, I know the Lakers didn't have a lot of room to make things happen because they're in a pinch financially.
Mm-hmm.
So to go out there and get Westbrook, I like the aggressive move. You've only got about a year or so, maybe two of LeBron's prime. You've got to maximize the window. Tiki's absolutely right. If they rolled out the balls in camp with the same roster they had a year ago, they're going nowhere. They're probably going to trade Kuzma. You add there. Again, I don't know if DeRozan might take that mid-level. There's like a mid-level exception on steroids, for lack of a better description.
I liked DeRozan before Westbrook was with the Lakers.
What if you have DeRozan coming off the bench? I don't know if he would love that, but I just
worry. Who's the three-point shooter?
Well, but that's where I was going.
Yeah.
Understanding the Lakers were limited because of the financial restraints. Here's the problem the way I see this construction. Now, number one, he's never been an efficient scorer.
Mm-mm.
He's always been, a pound it, self-create, pound it, always has the numbers, always plays hard. I really respect Russell Westbrook. But, framing this from, is this team now ready to win a championship? You're taking a player who has never not been the focal point of an offense outside of a snippet in Houston and a snippet with the Wizards, right? His entire career has been really built on monopolizing the ball. Is he going to monopolize the ball with LeBron James?
No, but he might be a creator for LeBron James.
Well, but here's the thing. He only creates in a way that either takes a lot of time or is inefficient.
Mm.
And the more time that the ball is in his hands and not in LeBron or AD's, there will be more inefficiency than I think the average fan's incorporating within this move. Like, don't get me wrong. It's sexy. Yeah, Westbrook. Oh, he's going to have some nights where he gets triple-doubles and they put up a buck 30 and they beat good teams. I'm not saying this is a horrendous move. I'm viewing this through a championship prism. You have a guy who is now asked to change his entire mindset because he can't. He cannot play the way he's always played, and that's a monster adjustment at this age.
It is. It Big. Is. He's 32, going to be 33.
He's played one way for 30 years.
But did not James Harden completely change his way of playing when he went to the Brooklyn Nets? You know, remember, he was the guy.
Uh-huh.
He was this volume scorer. I'm taking every shot. I'm getting to the rim. I'm doing all of it for the Houston Rockets. He goes to the Brooklyn Nets. He's like, I'm not going to play second fiddle. I'll sit third chair here,
mm-hmm.
right, and be
yeah.
the facilitator. And that it actually surprised me that James Harden went that way and became that the glue to that trio. Maybe Russell Westbrook can evolve into that.
I don't see it.
I don't. I mean,
can I tell you why?
I didn't see it with James Harden. I was shocked he took that second step, that back seat.
Mm-hmm.
Why can't Russell Westbrook?
Here's
do
the
that?
Difference. James Harden, just the way his game is.
Mm-hmm.
James Harden, when he came to the Nets and he looked himself in the mirror and said, okay, if I really want to win a championship, I've got to not acquiesce, but I've got to kind of rebrand and repackage how I do things, right? And his skill set allowed him to defer early, but because he's far more efficient than Westbrook, when it was time to shoot,
yeah.
the ball was still dropping.
Yeah, you're right.
So
fourth
if Westbrook,
quarters, you'd see that happen.
Exactly. So if Westbrook, even if Westbrook tries, and I don't doubt that he will try. I'm not saying that Westbrook's right now, like, hey, man, you know, LeBron's going to fit my game. No, I'm not implying that at all. But while he tries to modify what he does and alter how he does it, the amount of shots that he gets, he will not approach James Harden's level of efficiency. Again, championship prism. That's all I'm viewing.
Yeah.
Well, if you want to win 50 games, of course it works.
And that's all you can do, BT.
That's all that matters with
no
the Lakers.
There's no reason to bring in Russell Westbrook if you're not looking at it from a championship prism. You're not.
I agree.
You're not looking to, hey, we got to grow these three guys that are sitting on the bench and, you know, get them ready for when LeBron. Win a championship. They mm-hmm. are win now. Maybe as win now as any team in the NBA, to be perfectly honest with you, BT. Maybe the Nets fall in that category as well, but because their contract situations with the guys can opt out. But
yep.
the Lakers are certainly that way.
Uh-huh.
I mean, LeBron's 37 years old. You know what I mean? And AD is he's got one already, but still it's AD. He's trying to determine his future.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, the Lakers are absolutely win now. I think it helps them only because
I think it helps them too.
I
just don't think they win a championship.
I believe Russell Westbrook can change his stripes.
So here's what I do love about the Westbrook move. And I can also say this, I don't think it's a championship move, but I do love this aspect. With AD's injury history
mm-hmm.
and LeBron's attrition and mileage and age, you now have a guy. Now, you can't do this every night because it will be to their detriment. But there could be a couple of nights where you say, okay, we're going to sit you down, LeBron. We're going to sit you down, AD. You can mix and match. Hey, Russ, the leash is off, buddy.
Yeah,
go get us
thing.
40
yep.
and go do your thing.
And that'll be valuable in the regular season.
No question
right?
about it.
So,
and not going to win you championships,
no.
but it will keep those guys fresh.
That's right.
And especially be in a better position to win the championship.
Because AD always has injury stuff, and LeBron's just getting older. It is what it is.
Yeah.
I like it because it's the best move they could have made to keep themselves at least championship relevant. Because I think, and we said this at the beginning, if they run it back as they were, they're not keeping up with what's happening in the
nope,
West.
I agree.
So they had to do something. This mm-hmm. was their best bet, and you never know. Maybe Russell Westbrook turns into what James Harden became for the Brooklyn Nets. Maybe he doesn't, but you had to try something.
Yep.
And I give them credit for at least trying.
I do too. I give them credit for trying.